What's up, guys? Cojina Racing here with another awesome video. A couple months ago, I did a video about how much it costs to build a 500 horsepower 335i M55 engine. And that video is the video with the most views. If you haven't seen that video of how much it costs to build a 500 horsepower BMW 335i M55 engine, I'm gonna link it right here so you can go and see it. So I was thinking about doing like a second part or something similar to the topic. So in this video, I'm gonna be telling you how to build a 500 plus horsepower BMW 335i M55 engine. Coming up. First thing, you have to make your car full bolted, right? To make it, you need an intake. In my car, I'm using the BMS Goddard intake. I'm gonna put a picture right now. So you're gonna need a Goddard intake. That intake gives you like 20 horsepower, I think, 15, something like that. So yeah, first mod, a Goddard intake, a BMS intake. Second thing that you need, aluminum charge pipe. The one that I'm using on my car is the Phoenix Racing aluminum charge pipe. It doesn't give you any horsepower, but you know, BMW have the plastic charge pipe. So if you build a car with the, the plastic charge pipe, you're gonna blow it like nothing. Even I blew mine when I was stuck, so definitely you have to upgrade it. No matter if you don't want to upgrade your car or you're still going to build it, upgrade the charge pipe because it's going to be way better on the long run, believe me. So the second thing, aluminum charge pipe. Third thing that you would need to reach your 500 plus horsepower on a BMW 335i M55 engine is a downpipe. It's up to you if you want cutless or cutted, but I went with I went with cutless downpipe just because I like to be my car way more louder. I buy the BRSF cutless downpipes for the E55 engine with the muffler delete. I don't have exhaust, so I delete the mufflers with the downpipe, so it's close enough to a straight pipe car. So yeah, that's the third thing, the BRSF downpipes. The thing number four that you need to build a 500 horsepower BMW M55 engine. First, you have to upgrade the front mount intercooler, make it 7 inches or I think 5 inches is another one, I'm not sure. So yeah, I'm gonna go with the BRSF 7-inch front mount intercooler. For my car, I have a battery already, I'm going to. You need a front mount intercooler, depending, but if you want to reach the 500 easily, go with the 7-inch for the BMW 335i. The fifth thing that you're gonna need, of course, the tune. Doesn't matter if you go with JB4, MHD, Cobb, whatever. I personally, I choose the JB4 just because I like the feature of having the boost gauge on my fuel gauge. I don't know if I'm saying that right. But yeah, I like that feature, so I went with the JB4, but you can go with MHD too. It's really good. I think those two are the best one. My personal opinion, that's what I think. Maybe you have a different opinion. If you have it, please comment down below which one you think is better than MHD and JB4. But for me, I think those are the top two ones when it comes to tune your BMW. That being said, once you put the tune on your car, you can put E85 on it. So that's a plus. Because even with the stock fuel pump, you can put like a E30 mix on your car. I did it already on mine with the JB4 only. I put the JB4 on Mach 5, if I'm not mistaken. That's the auto tune map. And then I put the, I think it was like 10 gallons of not 10 gallons, 4 gallons of E85, and then the rest on corn gas. So I make like E30 means, I don't think I made the E40, but I'm pretty sure it was E30 means. And that gives you a couple of extra horsepower. Well, another thing, you can use the JB4 and do the MHD back and flash. And you got it right there. You have a couple extra horsepower over there too. So now that we have the charge pipe, down pipe, front mount intercooler, the tune, and the intake, something that I would recommend you to do is upgrade the fuel pump so you can put more E85 on it. So I will go with the stage 2 fuel pump. So you can put like E60 mix on the car. That really is gonna give you a lot of horsepower over there. So yeah, the 6, I think. The 6. Thing number 6 that you will have to do, or I recommend you to do, is upgrade the fuel pump so you can get that extra horsepower over there. And last but not least, of course, you need to upgrade your turbos. I didn't mention this on the other video, but you need to upgrade the turbos to reach the 500 plus horsepower to the wheel on a BMW 325i M55 engine. And I don't have the M54, that's a difference right there. I have the M55. It is faster, it's slower, it depends. I have seen M55 going really fast, and I have seen M54, so both of them are really good engine. People rather have the M54 because they got the quick turbo, blah 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 blah. But the M55, if you think about it, the M54, they made a single turbo to make horsepower. The M55 already had a single turbo, twin screw. So you just need to put a bigger turbo in it, and let's go over 500 horsepower like nothing. So the one that I'm gonna be getting soon, after I finish my full Bolton car, is gonna be the Pure's turbos. I'm gonna have a link of all the mods that I just mentioned down below, so you can go and check it out. But I'm gonna be getting the Pure's turbo for my M55. And with that, tune the car on the dyno, and I'm pretty sure I will be over 500 horsepower to the wheel. And my car is all-wheel drive, so I'm not gonna be spinning all around. I'm gonna have 500 horsepower to the wheel, and you know, to the ground.
Please report it ahead.
Thank you. With those, I think 7 mods that you do to your cars. Yeah, I think there were 7. You're gonna be at 500 wheel horsepower for sure. But if you want to go a little further, then you can always do like port injections, be full 100% E85 too. So there's a lot of things to do to this platform. But if you just want to reach the 500 horsepower and stay there, like for more reliable car,
please report then, it ahead.
Anyways, for 7 mods, you should be able to get the 500 wheel horsepower. I'm pretty sure you can be able to reach it. So there you have it, guys. 7 mods that you can do to your BMW M55 engine to pass over 500 wheel horsepower. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, please hit that like button over there. If you haven't done it already, please consider subscribe, because there's a lot of content coming up. I don't only do BMWs, I do a couple different cars of my buddies. So yeah, stay tuned, make sure you hit that subscribe button down there, and comment down below. And if you have a better option for two-year BMW, like MHD or JB4, like another different one other than those two, comment it down below so I can go and check it out. If you have a BMW M55 and you're planning on tuning it or build it or whatever, let me know in the comments. Maybe I can tell you what to expect when you are doing that, since my car is almost full Bolton already. You know, I have done a couple of things to my car, a couple of issues that I have been going through with the car, but nothing crazy, so don't be scared. If you want to do it, go for it. I really recommend it. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and see you on the next video. Wah!